Interspecies procreation? What the hell could that be? Oh, this guy's a doctor in dentistry, for your information. Whoa, hold on there. Most biosystems form in the Cambrian? While it's true that most of the 35 phyla in the animal kingdom appeared during that era, this predates many of the modern biological features, like spines and eyes. What? Whoever said that? I'll get back to that later. I want to see his point. Okay, we have what looks like some sort of shrimp thing with eyes and a trilobite with human ears. Wait a second. What are they doing? Oh my god, shut it off! Shut it off! Like, crap. I don't know. Just put on something. Anything else. Just... Okay, are we back on? Here's the point to all this. Dr. Steve seems to believe that the only way for similar biosystems to exist in different species is for them to have either been placed there supernaturally, or for an elephant to date rape a giraffe. He also seems to think that all organs and organ systems would only provide a function if they are in their present form and in combination with all other systems present in a species. If you had actually taken the time to do some research, you would find that there are much better explanations for the similarities between different species. It's called homology, and evolution simply would not work without it. Species retain traits from their ancestors, no matter how distant. This is a chordate, the progenitor of the phylum Chordata. It has no brain, no eyes, no bones, no hepatic systems, not much of a digestive system, no renal system, or many other features we just can't live without. But it still survived. It did have a primitive nervous system, a very simple circulatory system, and a mouth connected to an anal port. This member of Chordata, as well as all modern members, have a central axis called a notochord. In the subphylum vertebrate, this notochord in embryos develops into our spinal cord. In the subphylum tunicate, this notochord disappears at the end of the larval stage. They may not look like us, but like all chordates, they still have nerves, a circulatory system, and an intake port connected to an excretory port, just like we do. See that? No need for interspecies procreation there! No, they are not all interdependent. If you don't believe me, ask a jellyfish. They have no eyes, no brains, no bones, no hearts, no respiratory systems, no hepatic system, no renal system, no digestive system, no circulatory system. But they survive just fine. And despite not having brains, they still have nerves and are able to react to external stimuli. No, there is no need for there to be one progenitor for every organ on the planet. Convergent evolution. It is the process of similar anatomical structures evolving in different species, such as how bats and birds both evolved wings for flight, despite the fact that their most recent common ancestor did not have wings. Eyes are another good example. Eyes have evolved in several phyla, including vertebrates, mollusks, insects, and cephalopods. See that? No need for interspecies procreation there, either. Listen, Steve, the only thing you proved with this ridiculous farce is that you do not understand common descent or convergent evolution, or evolution for that matter. Instead of spending your time making bad jokes, why don't you actually learn something about the theories you're trying to disprove?